Hi again, folks. It's Sam with Hurting Boys. Today I want to talk about one of my favorites, and that is heel marks in the concrete. This occurs because boys don't want to be the one pointed at and laughed at. They don't want to be the butt of the jokes for the day of the group, and they're going to avoid that like the plague. So when mom says or dad says, hey, we're going to go see your cousin's dance recital, all of a sudden that feels like, holy crap, if my friends find out about that, I'm dead. They'll make fun of me from here till next Wednesday. So they're going to, you know, put their heels down and say, no, and that's the heel marks in the concrete. A couple of examples, and this is about being a courageous teacher, parent, you know, grandparent, whatever, with little boys. We're going to go do this. No. Well, one of our kids was about 9 years old, and the nearby high school was going to have a summer basketball camp for kids 9 to 10. And I said, hey, you're going to this camp. And it was immediately pitching a fit and great dread and fear in his eyes, because he was worried, since he'd never played organized basketball at that point, that he was going to look really stupid amongst every other kid in the gym. And for 2 weeks, it was kind of like that. And finally, I drove him over there, and he's, you know, just shaking. And we go inside, and all of a sudden, he's looking around. There's 100 little boys with the same look on his face. And there's some of the high school seniors and, you know, basketball team shooting jumpers and pretty awesome. Come up to a table, and they go, oh, hi, and here's your T-shirt. And we switched T-shirts, and I said, all right, I'll pick you up at noon. Left, came in the circle driveway, pulled up. He came bounding out of the door, jumped in the car, and said, basketball is my favorite sport. And that's the way it is. Boys will dread something, pitch a fit, kvetch the entire time something's going on, and then sometime later, either instantly or years, they will say, man, that was pretty cool. Glad I did that. Remember now, you're the parent. You know what you want your son to experience. By the time he leaves your nest, you want him to know some cultural things. You want him to know and have experienced some things that he wouldn't have otherwise sought out, and maybe someone else wouldn't have given him. Another example, and I'll close with this. We had an occasion to go to Hawaii many years ago, and our oldest was, I think, 16, turned 16 on the trip, and so the three of them. And we were on Maui and did the famed road to Hana. It's a long, slow, very curvy ride. I think there's more one-lane bridges than any road in the world or something like that. Anyway, we had done it years before and really enjoyed it, because out at the end of it are some pretty cool things. There's a black sand beach, great snorkeling and all that. But it's an hour and a half, a little bit, kind of slow. And these three boys were just, my gosh, like we were dragging them to the gallows or something. And whining, when are we going to get there, and all that typical stuff. Got there, had a lot of fun, and then drove back. And we're like ready to drown them, you know, because of the attitude. Well, here, just like now within the last year, so we're talking 15, 16 years later, they remember that as one of the greatest things we'd ever done. And there it is. Heel marks in the concrete. Boys will resist. Be courageous. Do what you want them to see. You know, do it. You'll enjoy it. You'll be glad you did it. And they will eventually. Thanks. I'm out.